Hello and welcome back. Today we're going to learn about the concept of quotients in group theory. And we're going to use this concept of quotients to learn about more deep concepts or more known concept of the, suppose something like that, the normal subgroups or the concept of quotient group, something like that. Okay, so before going to the concept of quotients, let me talk about the idea behind the concept. So what is going to do over here? Suppose we have a group G. So G is our group, and H, let H be a subgroup. So H is a subgroup of G. And we're going to use this subgroup H to decompose the whole group G. What is the meaning of the word decompose? Decompose means we divided the whole group into smaller pieces. So something like that. But here we're going to decompose the group in such a way that the size of the each pieces must have to be same. So that is the idea over here. And we have used this similar type of idea before. Where we have used this type of idea? Can you remind the concept of the set Zn? So here Zn is the collection of all class 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, class of residual class of module n. So n minus 1. For example, let me talk about the set Z3. So here Z3 is the collection of the elements 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar. So what is 0 bar over here? 0 bar is the collection of all such integers that if we divided that integers, we will get the remainder 0. So 0 bar is the collection of all integers of the form 3n. N belongs to set of integers. Similarly, 1 bar going to be 3n plus 1. N belongs to the set Z. And 2 bar, 3n plus 2. N belongs to the set Z. And you know that before learning about the concept of group theory, we can learn about the structures of the set of integers by learning the structures of 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar basically. So instead of learning the whole set of integers, we can learn about these classes basically, or the collection of the elements, that elements are the classes. So similar type of idea we're going to do over here. So what are we going to do over here? So here, instead of learning the whole group, so we have a group G. So instead of learning the whole group, we're going to learn the group G in some indirect way. So what is the indirectly? So we're going to use a subgroup H. We're going to learn the group G by using the concept of subgroup, or we're going to learn the group G by learning about its quotients basically. And for that, we're going to use this subgroup H. So this is the idea behind over here, idea behind the concept of quotient. So instead of learning the whole group G, we're going to learn the group G, but in some indirect manner basically over here. So let me talk about the concept. So let me give you the definition of left quotients. So left quotients. So let me let G be a group. G be a group. And H be a subgroup, H be a subgroup of the group G. And let me take an element, let A belongs to Z. And now for all H, if I take H from the subgroup H, you can see over here, here we have the set G and here we have the set H basically. So if I take H from the set H, then obviously the H have to be an element of the group G. So therefore, A belongs to, A is an element of G and H is also an element of G. And we have the element H, obviously, the belongs to the set G, basically. So if I take all collection of all such elements, so we are just taking all such collection. So H says that H belongs to the set H. Then this is the collection. This is some collection of elements of G, basically, because H are the element of the set G. So therefore, this is a subset. This is a subset of G, and this subset is called a left coset of H. So this subset is called a left coset. So H, we're going to use this notation. So instead of writing the whole set H in this way, we're going to use this notation AH. So AH is a left coset. So this is a left coset of G. So for different element A of G, we will get different left cosets of H. So let me take you, let me talk about an example. So here we're going to take an example. So let me talk about the concept by taking this example. So here we're going to take G equals to the, our group Z plus. So Z is the set of all integers and H is the subgroup 3Z with the addition. So what is 3Z? 3Z is the collection of all elements 3 into n. N belongs to the set Z. So basically, this is the multiplication of all multiplication of the integers 3. So it is the collection 0 plus minus 3 plus minus 6 plus minus 9 and so on. Now we just want to take, so A equals to 0. I just take A equals to 0, and this is the form, the set G, because Z, G is Z. So 0 belongs to G. Now we're going to talk about AH. Okay, one more thing I just want to talk about over here. So when we going to use the additive notation, something like we are doing over here, instead of AH, we use the sign A plus H. So AH is basically same with A plus H, but when we going to use the additive group, we use this sign. And in general group or in multiplicative group, we use this sign H. So here we're going to use A plus H sign. So here we're going to use 0 plus H. So what about the 0 plus H? 0 plus H means 0 plus 3Z. So 0 plus 3Z means, let me remind you what was our A plus H. A plus H means the collection of all such element. A plus H such that H is an element from the subgroup H, basically. So A is fixed over here. So 0 is fixed over here. And we just vary the element of from the set, elements from the set H. So we're going to vary from elements from the set 3Z. So it is going to be 0 and plus first element is 0 over here. You can write 0. So let me take another color. So 0, next element will be 0 plus 3 or minus 3, so 0 plus minus 3. Next will be 0 plus minus 6, 0 plus minus 6, and so on. So after the calculation, what we get over here, so let me clear this. So 0 plus H becomes the element something like 0, 0 plus minus 3, 0 plus minus 6, and so on. So if we add that element, we will get 0 plus minus 3 plus minus 6. Basically, it is the same set 3Z or H. So 0 plus H becomes H. So the our left coset, so H itself is a left coset, is a left coset of itself. So 0 plus H is a left coset of H. Now talk about, let me take another integers, 1. Now A is 1 over here and 1 belongs to the set G. So next 1 plus H means 1 plus 3Z. So 1 plus 3Z means, so 1 plus 0, 1 plus minus 3, 1 plus minus 6, and so on. If we look very carefully to the elements, you can see that the elements are is of the form 3n plus 1. N belongs to the set Z. Why? For n equals to 0, we will get the first element. So 3 into 0 plus 1 or just 1 plus 0. For n equals to 1, we will get 3 into 1 plus 1. So it will be 3 plus 1, this element 3 plus 1. If I take n equals 2 minus 1, we will get 3 into minus 1 plus 1. So this is minus 3 plus 1. This also you can similarly you will get 1 plus minus 6, 1 plus minus 9, and so on so forth. So once we get the elements, we basically learn about the whole sets, whole subset 1 plus h, which is the collection of all elements 3 of the form 3n plus 1. Now let me take another element 2. So let me take another element, which is 2 basically. So a equals to 2 over here. So 2 plus h means 2 plus 3z. This is going to be elements of the form 2 plus 0, 2 plus minus 3, 2 plus minus 6. And if you look very carefully, the all elements is of the form 3n plus 2 basically. So n belongs to the form, the set of integers. So in this way, we learn about the whole subset 2 plus h over here. Next, let me take the element a equals to 3. So what about 3 plus h? So 3 plus h is the collection of all such elements, 3 plus 3z. So this is going to be 3 plus 0, 3 plus minus 3, 3 plus minus 6, and so on. If you look very carefully, this is going to be the element 3n plus 3 basically. 3n plus 3n belongs to the set z. Now, if I divide it, we can write this sign, or we don't have to divide it. We can write as 3n plus 1. So n belongs to the set z. So this becomes all such elements is a multiplication of 3. You can see that here we have an integers and here we have a 3. So this is the collection of all integers which are the multiplication of the element 3. So this becomes basically which is 3 plus h. So our 3 plus h becomes. So 3 plus h is same which 3 plus h is same as h basically. So if we do, so here is the formula. You can see over here. So 4 plus h going to be 1 plus h. 5 plus h going to be 2 plus h. So for any n belongs to z, n plus h, either it will going to be h, or 1 plus h or 2 plus h. These are the only possible left quotients for the subgroup h. So when we get h, so if we divide, if we get the remainder 0, when we divided the integers n by 3, we will get h. So when we divided n by 3, if we get the remainder 1, we will get 1 plus h. When we divided the integers n and get the remainder 2, we will get 2 plus h. For example, let me take about 99 plus h. So 99 plus h going to be h basically. Why? If I divide 99 by 3, we'll get the remainder 0. So this will be h. So 100 plus h going to be obviously 1 plus h. Because if I divided 100 by 3, we'll get the remainder 1. So this is going to be 1 plus h. So similarly, if I talk about 103, so 103 going to be, if I divided it by 3, we will get the remainder 1 and we will get 1 plus h over here. I think was, let me take 13 divided 103 means 139 and 13, 4. This will going to be 1 plus h over here. So for any integers n, we can learn about the quotients for the subgroup h. So you can see that all the quotients, these are basically the same as the elements of z3. We'll learn about more about this concept, and in next video we're going to take another example, and from there we learn about the concept of quotients. So please come back in my next video, and thank you for watching till now.